Hello everyone, my name is Adrian Fernandez and welcome to another episode of Connect. Today we're bringing in Amit Ashara to talk about a vibration condition monitoring demo where we can do things like predictive maintenance by monitoring the vibration of a motor. So really excited to bring you on here, Amit. Do you want to give a quick overview of what we've got in front of us?
Thanks, Adrian. Yes, so what we have in front of us is the MSP432p4111 launchpad, which is a 2 MB MSP432p4 device.
Okay.
Which is talking to the CC2650 booster pack. And what we have on the topmost board is a 3-axis analog accelerometer.
That's right here. Okay.
Yes.
Cool. And I guess working all together, what's happening now?
So right now what is happening is we have the P411 launchpad, which is talking to the accelerometer.
Okay.
From which it gets 3 axes of data, X, Y, and Z.
Cool.
It samples it using the precision ADC that is available on our P4 devices. And after data acquisition and FFT, it uses the CC26xx device to transmit over Bluetooth.
Okay, very cool.
To a wireless device.
Okay, awesome. And you guys are doing an FFT on the X, Y, and Z accelerometer data to determine if we're in a good known vibration frequency.
Yes, and also look at the vibration profile to figure out if there are any internal issues with the motor without having to open the motor.
Awesome. So a person pulls their phone out and they're able to immediately see if there's something going on.
Yes, indeed.
Awesome. So, and that's exactly what we're able to do with this TI application.
Exactly. So, for example, when the green LED comes up, it's basically doing a sampling. So let's look at a very clean waveform.
Okay.
So I connect my app.
And for those that can't see, there is a little motor spinning here underneath this 3D printed platform. And right now it's a nice clean signal.
It should be a nice clean signal. So the blue LED is basically showing there is a transfer of data over Bluetooth.
Okay, awesome. And right now you're just downloading all that FFT data coming from the MSP device.
Right. So what I can see is the X, Y, and Z. I can switch off the X, Y, or see a particular axis of information. I can move between log scale or linear scale. And I can also save the data to my cloud service.
Oh, cool.
The way I want it to.
Awesome.
So as you could see that we have a very clean waveform, not too much noise.
Mm-hmm.
So let's try to introduce noise by actually using this pen
okay.
and touching it to the motor. So now the sampling is over, I will just connect and we will see that it would be completely different profile.
Gotcha. And we're using, the high resolution A to D of the MSP device, and this also is capable of high data sampling as well.
Yes, up to 1 MB samples a second.
Okay, cool.
So as you can see, the waveform has completely shifted and it has done significant amount of damage to this pen. So imagine a factory operation, a faulty motor can do some serious human damage,
absolutely.
Machine damage, cost, liabilities.
Right, right. And a line down situation potentially.
Absolutely, production stop.
Cool, and what we have here is I guess the ability to monitor the motor in real time, but if we had a Ethernet or Wi-Fi connected gateway, we could actually enable remote monitoring of the motors.
Yes, you could use machine learning on a cloud service to be able to plot expected time of failure.
Gotcha, very cool. Awesome. Well, thanks so much, Amit. This is a really cool demo. I can definitely see how this is key in an industrial setting. Do you know how developers can get started with this particular setup?
Yes. So they can use the TI design number, TIDA, on TI website.
Okay.
Or
cool.
They can go to TI.com and type in vibration condition monitoring to get access to the resources they require.
Very cool. Well, thanks for hanging out, Amit. Very cool demo. Be sure to check out the TI design that Amit talked about here to get started with your own motor fault monitoring system. You can also tune in next week where we'll learn more about new SimpleLink platform products. Additionally, get started with some of these applications that are available on the TI design demo.